it's been great, you know, ever since we worked in the first film. We didn't interact too much in the first film because we didn't have too many scenes together. But, you know, we got to know each other through the promotional campaign of Dirty Picture. And we've had that one scene which everyone talks about in Dirty Picture that didn't complete actually the love story. And also that's a Anduri Kahani. And, you know, with all the hatred through and through the film of Silk and Abraham abusing each other and, you know, almost getting to each other's throats, there's that one scene where Abraham comes to Silk's house. And people say, God, if there's any one romantic scene that sums it up for us, it's that scene in Dirty Picture. So people have been telling me that, you know, why don't we do an out-and-out romantic film with Vidya, because that scene was so explosive. We want to see that in our two-hour film. And then it was made possible recently with Hamari Adhuri Kahani. So for everyone who's been in love, I'm sure you can enjoy that and fall in love again, because, you know, the chemistry is something you don't have to work on. I think that comes across, and hopefully you'll see that in this also. So it's been great working with her on Hamari Adhuri Kahani.
कभी हम बाहर जाते हैं तो हम भी ऑफेंडेड फील करते हैं. आई एम नॉट सेइंग वी कॉन्शियसली ट्रीट पीपल बैडली और एनीथिंग. सो समटाइम्स you know, these things happen, but I think it works both ways.
I think mehman ka bhi responsibility hota hai how they when they go to somebody else's house.
A lot of recent cases comes where, you know, koi aana hai, cases happen, ya phir jab yahan pe aate hain, they do not treat them well. So, jo atithi devo bhava line.
I think there is no other country that's as welcoming or warm as India. We Indians make everyone feel at home, so I think that's very unfair of you to say.
Thank you.
You know, I haven't done a love story after Parinita, so. But this is a beautifully intense love story, and I'm glad that, you know, I'm part of this film, because it's special for me in many, many ways. One, I've always wanted to work with Bhatt Saab, Mahesh Bhatt Saab, but he gave up direction before I became an actor. So on this film I've got, you know, I've had the chance to work with him because he's written the film. And and again, I shouldn't be saying this in front of Mohit, but genuinely I do think that Mohit has, through all his films, that ability to touch you, to stir you, to move you, and that's what this film, this love story requires. So, and of course, I'm pairing up with the Imran Hashmi again. So, and Vishesh films, you know, I never thought really that in my career I would do a Vishesh films film, because the kind of films they make are very different from, for some reason. So I was so thrilled when I got that call to be part of this film, because I said, okay, one more tick mark, and a very, very special one of that.
So, what's that one special thing which touched you in this whole story? It's a love story or a adhuri love story?
It says it's Hamari Adhuri Kahani, and कहीं ना कहीं हर कहानी अधूरी होती है. Mohit ने अंदर radio station पर कहा कि एक कपल में अगर एक गुजर जाए तो उनकी भी कहानी अधूरी ही रह जाती है. तो हर कहानी अधूरी होती है, एंड आज इज ऑल्सो एन अधूरी कहानी. वॉट टच्ड यू मोस्ट अबाउट इट इज द फैक्ट दैट इट इज अधूरी, एंड अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम्स व्हाट यू थिंक ऑफ इज ट्रू लव एंड्स अप बीइंग एन अधूरी कहानी. बहुत बहुत कहानियाँ. पर आप पर्सनल रिलेशनशिप्स की बात कर रही हैं, मैं जिंदगी की बात कर रही हूँ. मेरी पहली, मुझे एक्चुअली लगा था कि मेरा ये फिल्म एक्टर बनने का ख्वाब अधूरा रह जाएगा, ये कहानी अधूरी रह जाएगी, बिकॉज मेरी पहली फिल्म मलयालम फिल्म बीच में रुक गई थी और बहुत सालों तक उसके बाद मुझे कोई फिल्म नहीं मिली, या तब लगा कि ये मेरी अधूरी कहानी होगी, पर thankfully I'm sitting here in front of you.
I mean technically मुझे लगता है कि फिल्मों में कहानी खत्म होती है, actually real life में कहानी खत्म ही नहीं होती है. As she said, you still keep loving. It's not like my story with my wife. One person I love is over. It's still going on. We keep evolving. Or I think that's the one distinct thing that what people are connecting with this film. I think it's somewhere considered as a real film. Kind of like emotionally identifiable.
ओके विद्या, जिस तरह की फिल्में मोहित करते आए हैं, चाहे आशिकी 2 की बात करें या विलन की बात करें, कहीं ना कहीं यू नो लव स्टोरी रहती है फिल्म के अंदर. अगर मैं अधूरी कहानी की बात करूं, किस तरह से उन फिल्मों से जुदा होगी, एक मैच्योर स्टोरी लग रही है, मैच्योर लव स्टोरी लग रही है, मैं कहना चाहूंगा किस तरह से अलग होगी जिस तरह का सिनेमा मोहित करते हैं, खास करके लव स्टोरीज को लेकर.
नहीं, आई थिंक जैसे मैंने कहा कि मोहित ने एक जॉनर अपना बनाया है लव स्टोरीज का. लव स्टोरीज में हिज फिल्म्स आर वेरी, उसमें कोई आर्टिफिस नहीं होता, कोई सुपरफिशियलिटी नहीं होती. और हमारी अधूरी कहानी किस तरह से अलग है वो एक्चुअली वो बता पाएंगे.
आई थिंक लव का लैंग्वेज इतना अलग होता नहीं है. आई थिंक अगर आप कह रहे हैं कि एक पॉपकॉर्न रोमांस नहीं है, ये नहीं, बिल्कुल नहीं है. और वो आशिकी में भी नहीं था और वो विलन में भी नहीं था. आई अंडरस्टैंड दैट, बट वॉट इज अनयूजल अबाउट इट, के कहना कि ये एक कहानी ऐसी हो सकती है जो आपकी आसपास किसी ने आपको सुनाई होगी. कहीं ना कहीं आशिकी एक स्टार की कहानी थी, पर ये कहानी आपके आपकी खुद की हो सकती है, आपके मदर की हो सकती है, आपके फादर की, इट कैन बी समवन दैट यू नो, योर सिस्टर, ब्रदर. इसमें जो, क्योंकि इसकी जो सोर्स है जो भट्ट साहब ने कहीं ना कहीं लिखी है, वो कहीं ना कहीं अपनी खुद की ज़िंदगी से, अपने पेरेंट्स की लाइफ से, इमरान की पेरेंट्स की लाइफ से, कहीं ना कहीं उन्होंने उधर से ही ड्रॉ करके ही इज़ मेड रेफरेंसेज ऑफ अ फिल्म लाइक दिस. और मैंने अक्सर ये देखा है कि जितना आप पर्सनलाइज करो कहानी को, वो उतनी यूनिवर्सल होती है. इट्स अ वेरी स्ट्रेंज थिंग. मैंने देखा है कि अक्सर जब कहानी ऑटोबायोग्राफिकल है, खुद होती है, ज़्यादा लोगों को छूती है. आई डोंट नो हाउ,
बट यू नो रिसेंटली वी सीन द ट्रेंड ऑफ यू नो स्मॉलर फिल्म्स लाइक क्वीन कहानी, मोर रिसेंटली
आशिकी
टू डूइंग रियली रियली वेल एट द बॉक्स ऑफिस. यू नो दिस क्वेश्चन फॉर ऑल थ्री ऑफ यू, डू यू थिंक इट ऑल बॉइल्स डाउन टू कंटेंट इज किंग?
ओह ऑफ कोर्स.
None of us would be sitting here if content wasn't king. I think it stands the test of time, and I think that's a very heartening trend now in the industry. We've seen that the film drives itself, and when you have a film that has powerful content that goes and connects to a lot of people, and that's what we were just saying in the last interview, you can't bulldoze the audience into a hall just by some, you know, marketing push. There has to be some soul in the marketing push, and that soul comes from the content in the film. So we have seen that films that might even start off slow go for long runs in the, you know, and they endure for weeks together. So it's a great trend that films are working for films, and when the audience comes in, and there's no better publicity than word of mouth, and we all know that when the audience comes out of a 12 o'clock show on the first day, they either make or break a film. So when they go out there and tell their friends and family that go watch this film, it's a very unique film that reaches my ears also. It somehow just spreads very fast. And that's the best, way to judge a success.
Surprisingly, it doesn't work with celebrities tweeting about and saying that the film is very good. It's really amazing.
Yeah, people have started looking through
those
things.
It's amazing that people say that about certain films, or whoa, they still don't go watch it. But if a friend of yours, probably a person you don't even like, who says, "Oh, that film is really good," you might still go watch it. I don't know why.
Imran, music plays a very important role in all your films as of now. So, what about this film? What role does music play?
I think music has been playing a vital role, not just in my career, in a lot of actors and films, to drive a central emotion, because Hindi films are all about that unique melody that kind of runs through the film, that becomes almost like a spine for the film and what it has to offer. So yes, I've been very grateful that in my films I've had enormous success through also the soundtracks of my films, and very memorable ones. Hamari Adhuri Kahani, without mincing my words, I can say is that if I have to look back at my career and see all those albums, and a lot of them, thankfully to all the music directors and directors who have made that possible, this would be up there with the best. Maybe a track like Hamari Adhuri Kahani or Ae Hamnawa, it's something that will really move you. And you'll know this when you see the film, so I don't want to harp too much about it, but when you go into a cinema hall and see this film, if you're not moved to tears with the romance, and which is heightened by the music of, maybe when a Hamari Adhuri Kahani, the title track plays, you will be moved to tears in the film. And that's the power of also the music that kind of lifts the emotion in the film. Well, thankfully, my story is complete. My marriage is complete. And now, for 9 years, we are happily married. But I think in all our lives, there are sometimes instances. It will probably not be a relationship, it will be a friendship. Which a tragic end. You get a soulmate and you are, very comfortable around. So I think in all our lives, that person comes. And we wished we could hold on to that person. So yes, like all of us, I think even I've had that in my life.
One last question.
Vidya touches on last domestic violence. How much did that affect you as an actor? Or did that take a toll on you, probably enacting those scenes?
No, it didn't. But I think when I read the script, it was obviously a bit out of my realm of reality, because you feel that, at least people around me are not going through things like that. That becomes your reality. But at the same time, you're aware that domestic violence is something that women are dealing with from all walks of life, and most often it's not spoken about. So you think you're, the people around you are, safe or... So I think I was disturbed when I read it, and I didn't know how it would play out. But I think given in the film and the way it happens, it felt very... She is a traditional woman who believes that she is her husband's property. So she has never questioned how he controls her life, how he treats her. And therefore, for her, for the character, it didn't seem, though it hurts, it pains, it's for anyone going through that, I think it would be difficult, but it's just her reality. There's something that she has to deal with until, someone else shows her respect and value and love. She doesn't realize that, she could be treated differently.